Hello, this is Sasha Stone, and this is my Wednesday live coaching call. And today's topic is about people that drive you crazy, and particularly people that you're kind of stuck with. They're not necessarily people that you are consciously choosing to be around, but they're in your life because for one reason or another, they just kind of have to be there. And today's topic was inspired by a question that I received. And so I'm going to start by reading the question and we'll go from there. And the person who wrote in would like to remain anonymous, so I'm not going to use their name. So anonymous writes, "My ex-daughter-in-law is still part of my life because of my grandchildren. Whenever we're in town visiting, we like to spend as much time with our grandsons as possible, which of course means we see their mother. We did not have a good relationship while she was married to my son, and it's even worse now. It's to the point where I have a hard time even looking at her. The sight of her sends me into instant anxiety. Yet I still make a point of saying, 'Hello, how are you? How was your weekend?' And I get nothing in return. No, 'How are you?' No, 'Thank you for looking after my children.' We do so much for our grandchildren and she shows no appreciation whatsoever and most of the time is cold and rude. What I want to know is, how do I get rid of all these horrible feelings and be able to deal with her from a neutral place? Thank you for your thoughts." So this is such a great question because this person is not asking, how do I change this person or how do I make them treat me differently? They're asking, how do I not feel so disturbed by them? And that's really the best question you can ask because you can't change that person that's driving you crazy. That's the bad news, and that's also the good news. And it's good news because you have control over how you respond to them. And that's really all you have control over. So here's what I want to say about that. So something this writer mentions is feeling a lot of anxiety just in the anticipation portion of knowing that she's going to be around her ex-daughter-in-law. So part of what creates that anxiety is anticipating a terrible interaction, anticipating that it's going to be unpleasant. And perhaps, you know, I mean, I don't know the whole backstory of this, but she mentioned that their relationship was bad even while she was her daughter-in-law. So there might be a lot of past issues and baggage and just so much emotional weight that both of them are carrying around that's also contributing to these interactions being unpleasant. So a big part of what creates tension in these interactions is just the anticipation that it's going to be bad. And so in that case, when we enter into any situation with that mindset, then there's a part of us that's looking for the evidence that it's unpleasant. So, for example, looking for the evidence that, well, when I say hello, when I say how are you, how was your weekend, I get nothing in return. So that's evidence that this woman is a bad person, or that's evidence that this woman is not respectful or appreciative. However, it sounds like her ex-daughter-in-law is fairly consistent in her behavior. She's consistent in that she is not going to respond lovingly or in a friendly way. And therefore, there's absolutely no reason to expect her to. And expectations are another reason why we get really annoyed and frustrated with people, because we're expecting them to act a certain way that we want them to act, and that's just not who they are. And so when we walk in with those expectations and those expectations aren't met, then again, that's more evidence or more reason to be frustrated or annoyed by that interaction. So what I want to say to this writer is, Your ex-daughter-in-law is who she is, and she is showing you over and over again who she is. And to expect her to be any different is only setting yourself up for misery, because those expectations are never going to be met. If they are for some reason met, then you can be pleasantly surprised. But there's no point in putting any energy or anxiety into wanting it to be any other way. Instead, your job is to accept that person exactly as they are and to walk into those interactions being exactly as you are. So if it is in your nature to greet people in a friendly way and to ask them how they're doing, then do that and expect nothing in return, because you're operating from your place and she's operating from her place. And so the more you can be in acceptance, the less misery you're going to experience. And this applies to any of you who are listening to this live or who will be listening to the recording, anybody in your life who you have a relationship with that isn't necessarily by conscious choice, such as coworkers, your parents, your siblings, perhaps, your best friend's husband. There's all kinds of relationships like this in our life. And the more that you can accept those people as they are and not put any other expectations on them to be any other way, the less misery you're going to cause yourself. Now, for relationships that you are consciously choosing, like friends, like significant others, spouses, that's a little bit different, because you're choosing to spend your time with them. They don't have to be there. You aren't necessarily stuck with them. And I would argue you're not stuck with anybody in your life, but that's a whole other topic. However, this element of acceptance is still huge. It goes a really long way. And so the more that you can accept somebody for who they are and not put any other expectations on them to be any other way, the more peaceful you'll feel with inside yourself. And to then look inside yourself and ask, am I happy and am I accepting how I am? And if you're in relationship with someone and you cannot accept their behavior, you cannot accept certain aspects of their personality, then you need to ask yourself whether or not you really want to continue to be in relationship with that person. And that's where your choice comes in. And again, even with those people that you feel stuck with and that you're like, you know, I know technically I could quit my job and not have to deal with this coworker. Technically, I could never speak to my parents again, but you've decided, you know what, I'm going to deal with it. You have a choice in terms of how much time you spend with that person, how much you choose to engage in interaction with them. Whenever, you know, you choose to walk away from a conversation, that's all up to you, including the choice of how you, choosing how you feel about that person. So if you decide that that person is annoying and frustrating and horrible and rude and all those things, then you're going to have a terrible experience dealing with them. But if you decide this is just another human being, and they have their own personality and I have my own personality, and I'm just going to let them be them and I'm going to be me, and then that's it. And that doesn't mean you have to like everybody. That doesn't mean you have to spend a lot of time with people that you don't particularly enjoy. That means you're just observing from a neutral place. They are who they are. I am who I am. And I don't particularly enjoy my interactions with them. So I'm going to keep those as short and sweet as possible. But I'm not going to judge them. And I'm not going to judge me. I'm just going to let it be whatever it is. So I hope that is helpful to the person who wrote in and to anybody who's listening in terms of these different relationships that you might have in your life. So I'm just going to open up the line and see if there are any specific questions you have about relationships in your own life. And if not, I will move on to some additional recommendations. Okay, so none at this point. Keep going. Okay, cool. No problem. All right. So I was recently recommended a book, and I will say I only just started reading it, so I don't know yet how helpful it will be, but it was recommended by my coach, who I respect and who has never made a bad recommendation to me. And the book is called The Relationship Handbook. I wish I had it right next to me right now. I don't. I'm unprepared in that way. But I know that the author's name is George something. And the Relationship Handbook, the whole premise of it is around acceptance. And it's not for these relationships that we feel that we're just kind of stuck with these people. It's relationships that we're choosing to be in, particularly marriages, your boyfriend, girlfriend, the person you live with, your significant other. It's for those relationships, and it's all about this issue of acceptance. So I'm really excited to be reading that book and to be able to share more with you about it a little later on once I've taken it all in. In terms of essential oils that can help, there are really so many, because essential oils are so supportive of our emotional state. But there were two that came to mind as being particularly helpful whenever you know you're going to be interacting with somebody who just really rubs you the wrong way, and you want to make sure you keep your cool. So one of them is called Balance. By doTERRA. It's called the Grounding Blend. So that's exactly what it is. It's extremely grounding, meaning it's wonderful for helping with feelings of anxiety, anger, frustration. It really helps to support greater feelings of ease, of calm, of feeling rooted and connected, so that when you enter situations that might be a little bit anxiety producing, you're supported in being more centered in yourself. So the way that you can use this oil, because it's called the Grounding Blend, it's actually a wonderful oil to place on the soles of your feet. So putting oils on the soles of your feet is a way that you can have an effect on your entire system. So that's a great place for this oil. You can also just put a dab on your wrists and take a deep breath in, and then rub a little bit on your chest, on your temples. So that way you're receiving the effect of the oil as you enter into whatever space you're going into. Now, if you're kind of caught off guard by this person and you make it through the interaction fine, but you feel that you're left feeling a little bit frazzled or annoyed, you can do the same thing and use the oil after the fact to bring those emotions back down and to get back into your centered place. Another oil that I love is Cheer. And Cheer is called the Uplifting Blend. And I find Cheer to just be such a pleasant and lovely aroma that it just automatically puts me in a good mood. And so when you're in a good mood, then the likelihood of having positive interactions is so much higher, even with people who annoy you. So managing your mood in general is extremely important, because when you're feeling positive, you're going to bring that into your interactions. If you're needing a little bit of support with your mood, Cheer is wonderful. I like this touch version in a roll-on bottle, because you can just roll it right on to your body wherever you like. Take deep breaths in. It just smells amazing. And I actually wear it like a perfume in the summer, because it feels so summery and fresh to me. So that's another one that I recommend. So those are my recommendations in terms of additional support for dealing with these kind of relationships. Okay, so it looks like there are no questions, which is absolutely fine. So my assignment to you, my assignment to the person who wrote this in, is to think about whoever that person is that is rubbing you the wrong way, and really see them as an individual and special and beautiful human being. And they are who they are, and you are who you are. And all that is needed is for there to be greater acceptance of that. And acceptance of the fact that you don't particularly enjoy their company, and that that's fine too. Because if you're judging that, or you're feeling like a bad person because of that, that's not going to help either. So it's just all about greater acceptance. And once you enter into interactions from a place of acceptance and being fully who you are in your highest self, so in your most loving self, then the chances of having unpleasant interactions are so much lower. And again, really being conscious of the fact that you have choices. So use those choices. You don't have to stay in conversations longer than you want to. You don't have to have additional social time with people that you don't want to spend time with. You get to call those shots and draw those boundaries. So remember that and maintain those boundaries. Okay, so thank you so much for joining me today. It's always a pleasure, and I welcome your questions. Whenever I get specific questions, that's so helpful because people can really learn from that. It's extremely valuable to share your experience. So I welcome your questions. You can email me. I'll provide my email address below this video. And you can just send your questions in and we'll go from there. And if you're watching this replay on YouTube, I invite you to subscribe to this channel. And that way you will always get updates whenever there is a new topic or a new video. Okay, thank you so much. And you're so welcome, Rachel. I wish you all a very beautiful day. And I will see you next Wednesday. Bye for now.